Here's an autumn guide for brand new beginners. Welcome to Don't Starve Together. First things first, we have to start with settings. Go right ahead and turn off lag compensation and screen shake. Lag compensation will cause you to rubber band on other people's servers, and screen shake makes it really hard to fight bosses later. You already know if you're joining someone else's server or playing solo. I'm going to assume you're playing solo because that's harder every step of the way. If you're making your own world, go here and make certain to add caves. Most of the game's content is there, so we'll want them for later. Now, you'll want to choose a character. This guide will work for any character, although I'd recommend starting out with Wendy as she's very strong for newer players. When you load in, you'll be greeted by no helpful in-game instructions or anything like it, and the game is designed to mislead you to your death, so don't trust anything. Immediately, look to the ground. There's turf that indicates what biome type you're in. Near spawn, there should be a light green turf biome, which you should go towards. The starting resources you need are flint, grass, and twigs. Flint can be hard to find in other biomes, so make certain you find at least 2 flint in the grassy biome before continuing on. Once you find the 2 flint and 2 twigs, click on the tools tab on the left and make a pickaxe. Next, you can start to head around the outer edge of the map to start exploring. Keep an eye out for boulders to mine, especially boulders with gold veins in them. Along the way, keep picking grass and twigs until you get a max stack of 40 of each. Also, feel free to grab berries or carrots and eat them if your hunger gets low. Don't stockpile though, as food rots and don't starve, so picking it ahead of time is inefficient unless your timing is very good. After you find a boulder, mine it by equipping your pickaxe and holding the left click while hovering over it or the space bar next to it. Quick OP tip, you can mine faster by clicking really fast on it. If it's a normal boulder, pick up everything except the niter, as niter is completely useless for the strategy we'll be using. Using the rocks you get from the boulder, make a hammer, once again under the tools tab. Also use some flint and make an axe here. The hammer is used for destroying structures, and the axe is used for chopping trees, plus it's a good weapon. Also, watch out for approaching dusk and nighttime. At dusk, certain monsters will roam, such as spiders, and nighttime itself will kill you without light. You'll want to build a torch under the light tab before that happens. Also, take note here how the game tries to mislead you by putting the campfire and fire pit higher in the crafting order, which would make you a sitting duck waiting to be eaten at nighttime. As we continue on, keep a lookout for cacti, pig houses, lots of purple turf, clockworks, wormholes, and any biome with lots of rocks, particularly gold rocks is what we're after. If you find cacti, it's one of the best base areas in the game. Depending on what cacti type you are by, it may be the best or only the second best. This cacti indicates the Dragonfly Desert, the most efficient biome to base in. And this cacti indicates the Oasis Desert, the second most efficient biome to base in. And that one's also great for mega basing, so if you live a really long time and want to build a really big base, that can be good. Keep it in mind for later because you'll likely be coming back here once you do everything else. Just keep following that outline of the world. You can break down pig houses by right clicking on them with your hammer. They drop 2 boards, 2 cut stones, and 2 pigskin each. Grab everything they drop. It's all super useful for later. Don't worry, they won't get mad at you for stealing their homes. They're too stupid for that. Watch out for spiders or pigs nearby to the pig house when you break it. Sometimes they'll go real quick and try to eat the pigskin. I recommend you just break down 5 pig houses for now, that way you don't overflow to a second stack of boards and cut stone. Wormholes are instant teleports at the cost of 15 sanity. They're super useful, but as you're brand new, don't just go hopping in and out of it repeatedly, otherwise you'll get some shadow creatures attacking you when you're not ready yet. Feel free to go through once to check what's on the other side, and continue exploring from there, or hop back through to continue where you left off if you don't like it over there. Long range ones can also be a good location to base at because it can be an easy way to avoid danger and to go get resources faster. With gold rocks, mine a bunch. I'd recommend that you gather 17 gold or more in total, along with all the flint and rocks these boulders drop. If your pickaxe breaks, just make another one and keep going. Watch out for tall birds in these areas, they deal 50 damage and are extremely aggressive. I would also recommend that you don't mine any more boulders that aren't gold boulders because that'll get you enough rocks, flint, and gold just from mining those, so you're kind of just wasting your time mining other boulders. Purple turf indicates the swamp. This area has many monsters, but also some very nice items that we want. Don't enter at night or dusk time, and make certain to keep moving while you're in there. While in the swamp, there are stationary, extremely strong monsters called tentacles basically everywhere. You can know one is right next to you when your sanity starts draining and there are no other monsters around you. All you want here are 8 reeds, and if you run into pig heads on sticks, break them with a hammer for free pigskin. By the way, they'll normally be nearby to the path. Also, watch out for merms, and if you get stuck there at dusk, spiders and mosquitoes. Staying near the path is your best bet here because tentacles don't spawn on the path, so I would recommend doing that rather than outlining the swamp. Clockworks. These can be found randomly anywhere across the map. They're strong, mechanical mobs. You don't have real weapons or armor, so don't fight them. Sometimes useful items will spawn next to them, such as gears. If there are no bishops, you can quickly run up and gather the loot and run away. But if there are bishops, don't do that, as they use a ranged attack. If you don't find any stray gears, keep in mind where these clockworks are for later. You may also find touchstones while you're exploring. There are 2 per overworld, and they always spawn with pig heads around them. Break them with your hammer to get some free pig skin and some free twigs. Hey, real quick, like and subscribe, please. It's the only way YouTube knows that people like seeing these. Your overall goal here is to outline the entire world as much as you can. After you cover everything in the steps before, chop down trees with your axe to gather 4 logs. Once again, spamming left click will make you chop it down faster. Using these logs and the other items you've gathered so far to create a science machine and place it next to yourself. Build a backpack, 2 electrical doodads, and use the electrical doodads to make an alchemy engine, but don't place it. Press right click and you'll have it pre-built for later. And you do all of that just while standing next to the science machine, so make certain you're placing it somewhere where there aren't really many monsters around. Now you have a bit of extra inventory space to work with, and we can keep going. Next, set trees on fire that are isolated. Wait for them to burn and chop them down. Do this until you gather 12 charcoal from these trees. Now you can go ahead and build your base. I recommend you build at either the Dragonfly Desert or Oasis Desert. In the Dragonfly Desert, indicated by this cacti, make certain you build far away from the magma pools, which is the dragonfly set piece, which is a raid boss, and also avoid hounds. If you're in the Oasis Desert, just find an area with a lot of cacti to base by. Now go to the science tab and place your alchemy engine that you made earlier in the spot that you want it to be in. This is where you're gonna base. Here on the screen, the recipe for crockpots, which are under the food tab. If you don't have enough cut stone left to build 2, build some cut stone in the refine tab using those rocks you have. Place the 2 crockpots side by side with about an alchemy engine worth of room between them and the alchemy engine. Then place a fire pit between the alchemy engine and crockpots. Also build a birdcage under the structures tab nearby to the crockpots. And finally, build a chest under the structures tab. Place it a decent distance away from the other structures. That way, if your base catches fire later, it won't spread as much. You're almost done with your base. Build a rope under the refine tab, then go to the fight tab and build a football helmet. This gives you 80% resistance to physical damage sources. Build another one whenever it gets low on durability, you'll need it. You need 2 resources now, silk and gears. And by the way, earlier, if you found a tentacle spike while in the swamp, that's gonna help out a lot versus an axe here. If you decided to base in the Dragonfly Desert, you can actually get both of these just by running around the outer edge and opening up tumbleweeds. Both silk and gears are a 1% chance, but each tumbleweed drops 3 items, so a 3% chance. You only need 1 gear, but you need 4 silk. So I'd recommend you gather tumbleweeds for the gear and any silk you find up until then, and then do my next step here. Look for spiders, which we'll use an axe to kill these. Make certain you have 1 with good durability. During the day, find a spider den. You should already know where some are because you explored so much. If it's a tier 1 den, step on the web to lure a spider out, get it off the web and a bit away, then attack it by either clicking on it or holding the F key. If you attack a spider on the web, all spiders in the den will attack you at once. Once you have killed 3 spiders in the tier 1 den, destroy it for silk. You'll probably have all 4 after that, but if you need more, find another den. If it's a tier 2 den, you'll be luring 2 spiders at once. Get them off the web and desync their attacks. When one has already attacked, you can dodge it and immediately start to attack the other spider, which will stun it. Then, when the other spider starts to attack again, run again. Just keep killing spiders until you gather the silk you need. Don't attack the den because it will have guardian spiders. Also, You can build a little trap under the survival tab, which can catch spiders in it if you'd rather do that than fight them, but I'd recommend you fight them because they're pretty easy mobs that you need to know how to kill if you want to get better at the game. Now, if you're in the Oasis Desert, you still need some gears. You're going to kill a clockwork. Go to the clockwork or clockworks you noted earlier. We'll just tank it because that's easier. Just make certain you're fighting one-on-one. Don't get attacked by multiple. The bishop is the easiest clockwork to kill with tanking and has extra drops which are useful later, but normally he's accompanied by other clockwork. Grab the gears after killing it and head back to base. Make a bird trap under the survival tab and place it somewhere nearby. Then make an ice box under the food tab and place it between your crock pots. This would also be a good time to build a lightning rod, or earlier while you're building your base would be a good time, which will protect your base from burning down from lightning. Putting food in the ice box makes it last twice as long, so now you can gather food and hold onto it for a while rather than just grabbing a berry and eating it immediately. When the bird trap catches a bird, pick it up, then put the bird in the bird cage. Now you can give meat to the bird to get fresh eggs. Spoiling eggs can be cooked and fed back to the bird, which will in turn give you another fresh egg. So now if you find meat, you have a food that will never spoil as long as you pay attention. The desert may look like it doesn't have much food, but cactus is actually edible. Make sure to wear your helmet while harvesting it so it doesn't hurt you much. Then bring it back to the base, add a flammable to the fire, and cook the cactus. Bam! Now you have a great food that can also heal tons of sanity. If you need food, you can also use the crock pot. You need to know two major recipes. There's a whole bunch of recipes, but these are the best ones in the game. Meatballs. Any meat plus three fillers that aren't twigs. I like using the three berry, one monster meat recipe, or three ice, one monster meat recipe. This gives 3 HP and 62.5 hunger. Pierogi. One vegetable, one egg, one meat, one filler that isn't twigs or mandrake. I like this recipe. One cactus, one egg, one monster meat, and then I'll fill in the last spot with another cactus, berry, or ice, depending on whatever is easiest. Also, in later game, if you're a bit of a better player, you may decide to gather lichen from the ruins and replace cactus with lichen. This heals 40 HP and 37.5 hunger. Finally, build a thermal stone under survival. You'll need it for winter on day 21. If you have time left before winter, you can work on whatever you want. You're already prepared and ready for the upcoming winter struggles. I would recommend you find a way to gather big meat, whether that be through killing pigs, beefalo, tall birds, whatever you find is best here. That way we can make a better weapon called the Hambat for killing the deercops later. Hopefully you liked the video. If you did, if you could help me out by liking and subscribing, that would be great. I'll also be doing a winter guide. It should come up on the screen if it's already out.